The whole point of localism and decentralising from Whitehall is to let local authorities free, let them get on with it. General power commons is the biggest shift in power that local government has seen in a generation. And I really want to see local authorities make the most of that, fly with it, be innovative with it and really do some great, exciting things.
Local government now realises that there's absolutely no way they can continue the way that they were, so something's got to give. And moving forward, they're trying to be more entrepreneurial, trying to create new opportunities and protect their local economies as well at the same time.
We know of councils that are now setting up their own banks to be able to move money through. We've got councils that have set up their own companies that are working sometimes in partnership with private sector to deliver services. We've got councils that are back into building properties again. We've got councils looking to invest transport money to open up road links to get more sites built. So I think there's a real appetite there, but it's not universal.
Kent approaching £60 to £70 million worth of surplus profit.
So the key ingredient for driving economic regeneration and economic prosperity in local authority areas is increased investment in infrastructure. There has to be this breakdown of the traditional barriers, the public sector thinking that the private sector is just purely in it for profit and a quick buck. Profit is not a dirty word. If we set up joint ventures, legitimate joint ventures, such as we've done with our client in Torbay, then we've given multi-million pound savings back to the local authority and an income stream out of the joint venture.
Private-public partnership's not a new thing. In Kent, we developed out an old RAF aerodrome in Westmorling, started about 18 years ago, and now have 5,000 homes, 6,000 jobs created on that campus in a joint venture with Liberty Construction, an American property company. And we've produced that new village and seen a receipt into the county coffers for significant sums of money.
Well, I think there is a big step to be made where local authorities start trusting the private sector, understanding that they have a huge part to play, because it's the private sector that is growing in employment terms and they can provide a lot of services. They can do them cost efficiently, cost effectively. They should be able to bid for local authority work, to tender in there for procurement. And I think local authorities being innovative about that and finding ways to do that locally can be only a good thing for local economies.
I think local authorities can do a lot more than they are doing at the moment. I think it needs government to allow local authorities to become more ambitious and not to curtail their plans. And I believe that local authorities have the financial capacity to borrow in, where they could actually play a lead role in regenerating their communities and creating a totally different atmosphere.
If the local authorities can look beyond the next political cycle and look beyond the next procurement round, the opportunity to build long-term strategic partnerships where there's a vested interest for the local authority and for the private sector partner, then absolutely I think a lot more can be done.